In the start of the movie, guy named Ty Hackett woke up to get ready for his work. He also woke his brother for school. Mike. Ty's friend was at the bus stop to pick him up. Ty and Mike worked at a security company named Eagle Shield who transports cash in armored vehicles. The rest of the team was also there. One of the crew member, Baines, was showing off his shotgun. Ty and Mike greeted the team. In the next scene, Team Senior told them from now on the armored trucks will be equipped with GPS. Ty, Mike and Baines was seen in the next scene loading the money in the truck. When Baines said he noticed a van following them. They started the truck and they were going to the destination when their truck broke down halfway. The team tried to contact backup from the radio, but the radio was not working. Everyone was panicked. Then they saw a van coming to their way. The robbers came out of the van and placed a bomb on the back of the truck. But it did not go off. Then Baines and Mike started to laugh. Ty found out it was a joke their team was making on him. In the next scene, the crew was at a bar enjoying their moment when Mike told the crew that Ty's father was a great friend of his and cheered Ty. Because he was sad after hearing about his father, as his father and mother was no more. Then Baines asked Ty how many terrorists did he kill in Baghdad. But Ty did not answer him and went to the bathroom. On the way home, Mike told that Ty did not did anything wrong in Baghdad, he was protecting his team. And he did not know he killed civilians too in the combat. Mike said he should be proud he was so useful to his team. When Ty reached home, his brother Jimmy was painting an owl on the wall of the kitchen. Ty told him that it is not his bedroom and he should not do this all over the house. Ty said to Jimmy he brought him food and they talked about their parents, then. Ty said that everything will be alright and he will clear all the debts. Then the crew was on their job when Mike told Ty about the chief. He said that chief defended the money against 5 robbers and got hit by a lot of bullets in his back. That's why he uses a stick to walk. He further said there was a crew who hit the bank. They were masterminds, but they did a small mistake. They took very small amount of cash. They only took 4 million. And even till now they were not able to be catched, as they were no robbers but the security guards of the Eagle Shield. After when they delivered the cash, the chief arranged a meeting where he told them that CCD cycle will begin from tomorrow. When everyone left the chief's office, Ty asked chief for extra shifts as he wanted to pay off the debts. But he refused as there were no extra shifts. Ty thanked chief then immediately left the chief's office. When Mike and Ty was on their way home, Mike told Ty that his father and mother did not did enough for him and left him in debts and huge hospital bills. He said that his parents wanted to see him living the life of his dreams, but in the end it did not worked out. Mike tried to convince Ty that he deserves to become rich. At a hot dog stand, an officer named Jake got a dispatch call for a case. That hot dog stand was near Ty's house. They both ate the hot dog, and on their way home Mike tried to convince Ty that they really have to get the money. CCD cycle is about to begin and every bank tries to maximize the cash they got. There will at least going to be $40 million in one truck. The whole crew of Mike's is ready to make this move. Ty refused to do this horrendous crime. Mike said, "It's your choice, but if you changed your mind, meet me at the bus stop." When he reached home, the child agent was at home waiting for Ty. She told Ty that Jimmy is not behaving well in school and is suspended and arrested for making graffitis. The agent said that Jimmy has to go with her for Jimmy's better behavior. But Ty said that they both lost their parent this year and don't want to be separated. After hearing this, agent got no option but to leave. The next day Mike was at the bus stop, Ty did not came. Mike went to the work and told rest of the crew that Ty won't gonna come. Then suddenly Ty came in the locker room and told Mike that he is in. But Mike has to promise Ty that no one will get hurt. Everyone was shocked and happy because Ty joined. Then they went to the bank to collect the money. The bank guard said the Eagle Shield crew is clear and could have the money. Then Mike's crew got a confirmation call from the company. They said everything is good. Company told them that they will confirm the safety again after 1 hour. Then the whole crew took the money in an old factory. They took out the money. Suddenly Quinn, one of the member of the crew, noticed there is a guy on top watching them. They rushed after that guy and caught him. It was a beggar. When that beggar again tried to escape, Baines shot him with his shotgun. When beggar was struggling on the ground for his life, Ty came and tried to took beggar to hospital. But Mike shoot him. And told Ty he is not going to make it. Ty locked himself in the armored truck and tried to escape, but Mike caught him after a struggle. Then he turned on the siren of the truck. Officer Jake from the beginning was at the hot dog stand and he heard the siren. He decided to figure out what is wrong. On the other hand, the Mike pulled the fuse to make the siren stop. They decided to kill Ty. So they started to look for strong metal rods to break the hinge of the armored truck. As they could not break the whole door, they started to hit the hinge. When they heard a cop car is coming their way, they stopped and sent Mike to confront him. As he was about to leave, Ty again manages to ring the siren. Baines shot that cop with the shotgun and bring him inside. Ty created a distraction by blowing up one bag of money and took the other cop inside another truck. That cop was severely bleeding and Ty told the cop to hold on and provided him with some medical support. On the other hand, Mike sent Quinn, one of the crew member, to Ty's house to kidnap Ty's brother, Jimmy. Meanwhile, Ty called out another crew member named Dobbs. Ty told Dobbs that if he did not give the fuse of the truck to Ty, then they both are going to die. Dobbs agreed, and when he bring the fuse and plugged it, Mike and his team was behind him. They took the fuse and Palver, another crew member, killed Dobbs. Then Ty decided to cover all the windows is cash and he broke the floor of the truck to get to a higher open place to call the backup. And told Jake to hang on. As we went to the rooftop, Mike heard a voice. And sent Palver to check that voice out. When Ty told the backup, Palver was right behind him. Palver wanted to kill Ty, but he had a breakdown because he killed Dobbs. And he jumped from the factory, killing himself without hurting Ty. Ty went to the truck again. Then Ty decided to put bomb inside the last container of cash. Then suddenly Quinn appeared with Ty's brother Jimmy. And forced Ty to get out of the truck. They took Jack out of the truck too. And when Baines and Quinn opened the container, the bomb blasted, killing Quinn, and Baines and Mike was heavily injured. Ty decided to go to get the police, but Jimmy tried to stop him, but he had to go or they all would die. When Ty reached the Jack's car, Mike came in the truck crushing the car. Ty then ran on foot and Mike was chasing him in the truck, then suddenly Ty lured him in a hole, where Mike crashed the truck and died. Then Ty called the police. They all were in the hospital and Jack, who was shot with the shotgun, was now safe. Then chief of the crew told Ty that he would receive a big reward for risking his life for everything. Then Jimmy appeared and told Ty that they should go home and have some rest. If you enjoyed our video, consider subscribing so you won't going to miss any highlights from us. Thanks for watching.